They say the euro was made by a sword. They say the old euro bureaucrats sucked taxpayers' blood without warning, and drops fed back into the central bank, and euro notes and coins were forged. I say, the euro was made by a handful of cynical bankers and bureaucrats, people willing to give their lives for the most heinous criminal act of all, and a forgotten word for the rest of us. Signor Rush, first of all, I would like to help our audience at home to easily understand the Signor Rush system, because I know that it might be difficult getting the true meaning using accounting and legal terms. Talking about the central bank, let's see what central banks should do nationwide, setting aside for a moment the role played by the Italian bank. First of all, the bank should be a juristic person belonging to the nation. Second, what's the role played by central bank? Or better, what's the national bank role? To issue legal bank notes and coins on behalf of the nation, or better, on behalf of the nation's people, handing it over to the treasury, who will in turn distribute the money through the local authorities that are supporting the state administration. This is what central banks should do if they want to fully respect people's national sovereignty. What is happening instead? In Italy or any other country, the central or national bank is not a public company belonging to the nation, thus subject to public law, but a privately owned company and as such an LTD which purpose is to make money. As LTD, its shareholders are not bound to public auditing procedures, and the main purpose of such central bank is to protect shareholders' interests, and as it was not enough, issue bank notes on its own instead of doing it on behalf of the Italian people. Lending bank notes, please note the term lending instead of handing over, lending bank notes to the treasury, which in turn has to pay interest on the money borrowed. Basically, it's like if Bank of Italy prints out any amount as it pleases on colored paper sheets, goes to the treasury saying, these are 100 million euros, give me goods as a guarantee for the same value, plus pay me another interest for borrowing my money.
This is what technically speaking they call prime rate.
Exactly. Now let's see this evening scoop that was.
Then nobody should get upset if anyone is doing the same. I mean, anyone can print homemade colored paper sheets, yep, handing them over to, yep, the treasury. Should just deserve the same respect.
Exactly. Now, many of you know that I have a show around Italy where I'm
sorry to interrupt, but I just want to say that the mafia compared to these people looks like Salvation Army. At least the money stays in Italy and not sent abroad.
Let's not carry on with exaggerations, because someone already called us complaining about certain claims that have been made.
I have an international scoop for the audience of Interland. This is a banknote of our beloved Italian lira during the fascist period. Can you see it? Can you put it on focus, please? This banknote was issued around 1940-42. In the printing, we can notice the seal with the word Italia on it and the Treasury Department. On the back is printed the law punishing whoever prints fake banknotes. So this is a 70 years old bank note where its owner was printed on it, thus belonging to the treasury on behalf of Italian people. Now, let's go back to about 25 years ago. This is a 500 lira banknote, which I think everyone remember. Can you see it? On top of it, you can notice the word Repubblica Italiana, Italian Republic, which means this is a banknote issued by our state on behalf of the Italian people. Here we have a 1,000 lira banknote with Giuseppe Verdi's face on it, and abracadabra, something has changed from Repubblica Italiana to Banca d'Italia, Bank of Italy. So,
it's not a republic anymore.
Exactly. We have a truly and outrageous switch of powers regarding who is the owner of people's money. A privately owned company is now the owner of banknotes without people's knowledge and consent, with all economic and social issues this implies. Last, gli euro vengono stampati in Malesia ma anche nelle Filippine. This is a Filipino banknote. Look at what is written on top of this Filipino banknote: Republica Filipinas, Philippine Republic, and not Bank of Philippines. They are almost ranked among the third world nations, but people are recognized as the sole owner of their money. For us, instead, nations of the euro area, we are not recognized as the owner of our money.